Hey, welcome to a very quick, silly tool review. I don't buy too many ratchets and extensions. I have a lot of them already. I've had them for years, and they're from various quality manufacturers. But last weekend, I found myself doing a job, and I needed some universal joints. And the only universal joint that I've ever really used is this half-inch drive one from Craftsman that I think I've had for a million years. I don't really use these a whole lot, but I found myself in a situation where I needed to get to a difficult part on an intake manifold, and I just didn't have the universals. And if I did, it would have made the job a bit quicker. So anyway, this company, Motiv-X-Tools, their ad popped up when I was searching for a set of universal joints. And good job, guys, because your ad worked. I bought your product. You know, they got a whole thing in here of, you know, make us great. And the packaging is made in the USA. These are, I believe, from Taiwan, which is fine. Paid 19 bucks for these. But really, I hate to talk about packaging, but this thing's beautiful. This little sponge with, like, their logo perfectly emblazoned on here is just, I don't know. Stuff like this. I know I spent money on the packaging, and that's great. Like, I hope these tools live up to the hype. But what's really nice about this, and I did not expect this, is that it comes with a foam insert for your box. So you can, you know, I know people, like, go bonkers over these foam inserts. This is, like, real, it's like dense foam. Okay, anyway. So why did I get these over some other brands? Well, these are spring-loaded, and every universal joint I've ever used, I wind up wrapping with electrical tape because they're just too floppy. They wear out, and they just always fall down. The pins, over time, get very loose. These roll pins. Snap-on uses a different design. They use like a pin, and then they grind it down and chrome it, which is really nice. But these ones with the spring on the inside, I was like, well, that's pretty interesting. And I wondered how well these work. They lock in nice. This is a snap-on extension. So they do hold, but the spring, I am super impressed with the ability of this thing to not flop over on itself. The spring kind of keeps it relatively centered, but not so centered that it's rendered useless. That's pretty awesome, because I didn't know that they even really spring-loaded U-joints were a thing. The finish on these is nice. It's a nice satin finish. It's not a shiny chrome finish. I don't know how well it's going to hold up. But the other thing is there's an Allen head in here. These are screwed in, I believe. Not that I have any reason to take this apart, but there's got to be, like, springs and U-clips on the inside of this to give it the springiness, because the spring is not through the center. There's no visible spring through the center of any of these. And while I had this half inch guy, all right, and I mean, just to show you, you know, if I put on the drive here with this is immediately going to fall down, right? It's just going to flop down, which kind of renders these things, if you're going into a small area and they just keep doing that, they're frustrating. So you wrap them with electrical tape, which was just an old school fix. But the spring on this, again, is decent. These have, you know, the spring prevents this thing from completely going limp, and it just gives enough play that, like, this is not falling at a full 90-degree angle, rendering itself useless. It's kind of nice, right? But this is the guy, the quarter inch. It's the one I'm most excited about, because a lot of times these universals, you know, you got to go into a little spot with them. And again, the spring, you know, there's some decent tension here on this. It doesn't fall at a full 90 degrees away. But it's the spring is nice because it does not preclude you from actually using the tool. It's not so stiff that this remains rigid. So I kind of have yet to really, you know, use these for a job, but I don't know, for 20 bucks, like, that's amazing. Like, I mean, back in the day, you'd spend 20 bucks for three of these from, you know, maybe Craftsman or somebody. Again, like, I know you pay for everything, including the packaging, but like, this is just impressive. I did not expect the product to be presented this way. And I know that that sells, you know, Apple was kind of the company that started with the whole thing of make the box look pretty. But again, not only that is it pretty, but you could put this in your box. You could, you know, if you're a foam control kind of tool person, you got it. And I think that that says something, because I do know that the tool control foam is expensive. I know some companies spend, you know, they charge you thousands of dollars extra for the stupid foam. By the way, if you're wondering why I'm not a tool foam control fan, it's because when you get something new, if you've already cut your foam, you're sort of stuck. I mean, like, tools are a never-ending evolution of what you need and what you get. So just keep that in mind. I think the tool control foam is nice. I appreciate it, but it, to me, it limits you. Like, if you get a new ratchet, you have to cut new foam for your ratchet. If you just have like a good drawer system, like, they don't roll around when you move the drawer. That's all you need. Anyway.
I'm impressed. I'm far more impressed than this, but anyway, check it out. Motiv-X Tools. Thanks. Bye.